Hello, everybody. Well, thank you very much for coming to ICT Spring. And thank you very much for coming to this little talk I'm going to give to you about the metaverse. Don't you just love it when your slides don't work? I love that. But anyway, if you can make any any sense of that, you can reach out to me and say hi. And my DMs are open. DMs are open. Remember that? Let's have a look, see if this works. Marvelous. Well, in 1992, science fiction novelist Neal Stephenson used the word metaverse. I'm sure all of us remember 1992. And as great stories like Neuromancer, Snow Crash, Ready Player One became prophetic warnings as a sort of dystopian future metaverse. But this concept of the virtual world got recognition most recently when Facebook changed its name to Meta to reflect its strategic focus on this new interface. So in computing, the term metaverse is defined as a virtual reality space in which users can interact with a computer-generated environment and other users. And we got a taste of this many years ago when something called Second Life launched. I don't know if anyone's got a Second Life character. Mine is hanging in space somewhere. His name is Butch Zai. If you ever go back into Second Life, I think I've forgotten my password, to be honest with you. It's hanging in space, standing around. It's on a hill somewhere. Go and say hi. Butch Zai, X-I-E. But that was our taste of what it might be. Then we had also Activision's World of Warcraft, Zynga's Farmville. All of them were kind of metaverses of their own type. But this broad, vague definition is changing, is warping as technology companies, small and large, start to engage with this whole idea. So it's now being sort of talked about in terms of VR, AR, IRL, blended reality, mixed reality, but with a potential addressable market worth $13 trillion in 2030, according to some estimates. So there's no universally accepted definition of metaverse, but most feel it's something like where the built environment merges with the virtual environment. So digital worlds constructed for the purposes of gaming, commerce related to the physical world. Mark Zuckerberg noted last year that whilst we currently look at the internet, in the future we're going to be in the internet. We will be in the experience. So when it arrives, whether it's a tour of ancient Greece, perhaps, you could go and have a chat with Socrates, or a visit to a cafe in Sao Paulo from your living room. There'll be VR headsets, smart clothing, tactile responses, haptic gloves. I'm sure I think we can imagine a few uses for that. The metaverse is becoming customized and enhanced, ultimately, for every person. Or as virtual reality pioneer Tony Parisi published in October last year, a global network of spatially organized, predominantly 3D content. But to succeed, the metaverse, or anything that claims to be like that, will have to be not just passive, it has to be active. So for instance, instead of staring at images of a car, why don't we walk into a car showroom, feel the leather underneath our seat, have an experience of driving the car? Perhaps it will be personal to you. Plus, it also means to be a place where you can customize your own experience, customize who you appear to be. Zuckerberg last October said, during Facebook's rebranding as Meta, avatars will be as popular as profile images, but instead of a static image, there'll be live 3D representations of you. It all sounds a little bit old-fashioned in some sense, doesn't it? It's fascinating how they're effectively having to reinvent themselves in this way. But almost a year on, a fifth of employees at Meta, formerly known as Facebook, now work for the company's metaverse project. A fifth of the entire company is investing at a rate of $3 billion in losses per quarter. Per quarter, it's losing $3 billion in order to work out what this next interface is going to be. So it's throwing enormous resources at what it considers to be what might be the new version of the metaverse. On CNBC recently, Zuckerberg said he expects the metaverse to be massive and become a major part of his company's business over the next decade. We hope to basically get to around 1 billion people in the metaverse, doing hundreds of dollars of commerce each, he said. So they're big on AR and VR as the next smartphone, if you will. And of course, it means that they would be liberated from Apple and Google's control on the smartphone. And it's even planning things like pop-up exhibitions in New York, for instance, for its next headset. But how is the metaverse a business? The number of companies working on the metaverse grew from 200 in July 2021 to more than 500 now, according to market researcher New Zoo. So 500 companies are working on an idea of what they think the metaverse should be. McKinsey says that the metaverse will have a $5 trillion market value by 2030. But the valuation doesn't stop there. According to Citi Global, it says it's $13 trillion. People are plucking figures out of the air to talk about what the metaverse is. Disney, Microsoft, Epic Games, they've all announced plans to create metaverses of their own. The government of Seoul, the government of South Korea, is even putting billions towards a South Korean metaverse for the country. So, it's all a media game, remember. Facebook famously makes all of its money, most of its money, out of advertising. And veteran media mogul Martin Sorrell recently said at Cannes Lion that the metaverse is a very sexy idea, but we have a long way to go. So what are the earliest manifestations of what we might call the metaverse? Well, there's Horizon Worlds. This is obviously a Facebook's or slash Meta's idea of what it is. It's a free virtual reality online video game with an integrated game creation system developed and published by Meta. It runs on the Oculus Rift S and the Oculus Quest 2. Horizon Worlds acts like a sort of audio-based chat room. You've got Reddit crossed with Clubhouse, crossed with Discord, and it launched in December 2021. So you've got to remember, we're really very early in this whole game. It uses full 3D motion via the motion capture system, and it has a world called Plaza, which is the hub of the whole thing. And this is how Facebook, you know, or Meta, shall we say, envisages what you might do. This is the new desktop environment in the metaverse, as it were. And if you've got brands like Fender, BMW launching basically areas inside. It all sounds a little bit AOL, doesn't it, in a funny sort of way. But, you know, the question is, will these just be stale brand experiences? Oh, I visited the BMW shop in Horizon, right. We'll have to see what they come up with. The gaming industry is really the one to watch here, I think. You know, you've got... Oh, and Fender, by the way, is also launching an area. So you can go and try out a Fender guitar or something. One of the ones to watch, I think, is Roblox. It's one of the world's most popular games, the vast virtual world of mini-games, digital hangouts. Got 55 million users. Not just teenagers, even adults are using this as well. And it's become a platform where players can create their own games and capture value from it using in-game currency, using Roblox. So in-game currency, the ability to create your own experiences, these are the kinds of building blocks that we're looking for. And then, of course, you've got Fortnite. Strictly speaking, it's a game, but in many respects, it's being used like a metaverse. Rapper Travis Scott held an online concert in Fortnite universe in 2020. It was watched by 12 million people, and he made $20 million out of it. So definitely a money maker for him. Excuse me. Stagehand, can I have some water, please? Now, it's worth remembering that some big brands are keen on working on this. FIFA is making more money out of online games. Can I grab a water? Thanks, guys. at least as much money out of online games as it is out of actual... Thank you so much, mate. Cheers, thanks. At least as much money out of online games as it is out of the actual football. And there are independent metaverses. So you've got Sandbox. So this is a virtual world where players are given the opportunity to build and monetize their gaming experience built on the Ethereum blockchain. So the platform's owned by Animoco Brands. It purchased the rights to the original Sandbox mobile game in 2018. So this was basically a mobile game which they retro-adapted to blockchain, to cryptocurrency, and then launched their own crypto inside it. Sand is the native utility token that allows each user to buy and sell lands and assets inside the Sandbox metaverse. And this is sometimes where you get a sort of confusion going on, because you get people in cryptocurrency talking about the metaverse, and what they really mean is the ability to buy assets inside a game like this. And then you have people like Meta and Fortnite talking about their metaverse, where they don't refer nearly so much to cryptocurrency as the same, in the same way. And in fact, in Sandbox, you had Snoop Dogg, the rapper Snoop Dogg, created the Snoopverse with a $450,000 acquisition for an estate. Now, they've also got brands launching things inside the Sandbox. So Time Magazine is doing an area inside Sandbox. And then you've got Decentraland, which is also an independent metaverse, created by two Argentinians, Ari Melek and Esteban Ordano. It's been in development since 2015. It launched in February 2020. And it's a 3D virtual world with a browser-based platform. So users can buy virtual plots of land via the Mana cryptocurrency, and it uses the Ethereum blockchain, once again, the most common blockchain. And it launched When it launched in 2017, parcels of digital land sold for about $20. And it raised $26 million in its ICO, its initial coin offering, in 2017. And in April 2021, so remember, a parcel of land cost $20. And in April 2021, during a surge in popularity of NFTs, a parcel of land sold between $6,000 and $100,000. So that's a metaverse with actual property rights inside. Now, this starts to get very interesting, doesn't it? And you've got brands appearing like Samsung, Adidas, Atari, PricewaterhouseCoopers, for heaven's sake, Miller Lite, Sotheby's, all launched inside Decentraland. Dolce & Gabbana, Tommy Hilfiger, Estee Lauder have all launched inside Decentraland. Music artists like Deadmau5, Grimes have held concerts in the platform. So, and there are many other metaverses appearing, such as Vans World, Spatial IO, many others. So everyone's throwing mud at the wall to see what sticks, effectively. Nike has even announced, acquired a digital design studio to build its presence inside metaverses. Microsoft, January 2022, announced plans to acquire game developers to provide building blocks for the metaverse. McKinsey says consumers are excited about brands entering the metaverse. This survey McKinsey did shows that people are thinking about the metaverse even though they're not necessarily in them or experiencing them. Playing social games, shopping, attending a telehealth appointment, attending a live event, traveling to other places. I'm surprised going on a date is so low. Interesting, isn't it? So millennials are the highest spenders in metaverse-related digital assets, with $151 on average spent in the past year. Gen Z is spending about $47 per year. Gen Z consumers spend $107 on average in Meta-related assets. Then you've got, and there's a little bit of a slide there from McKinsey about awareness of the metaverse, you know, the kinds of things they're interested in doing. Then you've got brands like Forever 21, who launched a beanie hat in the metaverse, and then suddenly realized that it was so popular that they should launch the actual beanie hat in real life. So brands sort of playing with the whole idea from one from the virtual world back to the real world and vice versa. And so fashion is really sort of taking off as this in this idea. You've got shopping, retail, Baringa. Over a quarter of UK retailers are preparing to enter the metaverse, according to a report by consulting firm Baringa. And JP Morgan calls the metaverse a $1 trillion yearly opportunity, revenue opportunity, noting in a recent report that $54 billion in virtual goods are sold every year. More than twice is what is spent on music. That's double what is spent on music is spent on digital assets. However, we are missing a trick here because the metaverse has equally fascinating and large applications in enterprise and business. In January 2022, remember I keep saying January, April, December? It's all so new, completely new. So you really guys, you're in the right room. This is very early. In January 2022, Hyundai, in partnership with Unity, announced plans to build a platform for a meta factory to enable remote problem solving, test runs of new facilities, and simulations for consumers. So what we're doing, what companies are doing is they're building digital twins of factories, of work environments, so they can see how things might operate more efficiently before they've built the actual factory, right? So that's fascinating. And think about the money saved by doing that. BMW has worked with NVIDIA to create a demo digital twin of a digital BMW production facility. So these digital twins are expected to explode. There's also health metaverse. This company called 8chili launched a partnership with Aventin in March this year to develop a virtual reality platform to do training, patient engagement, etc. Health coaching. Financial services. JP Morgan launching in Decentraland. They launched a lounge. So they think that the financial services need to be inside metaverse platforms as well. And of course, remember I said the crypto world often merges with metaverses as well. And there's often this confusion about the metaverse and crypto. Whenever somebody says this to you, just say, what do you mean? Do you mean the crypto token, or do you mean a crypto metaverse, or do you mean a platform like Horizon or Decentraland, etc.? I'm going to have to, they're only giving me a couple of minutes to finish, so let me just wrap, go quickly. You've got the new headsets. This is the new headset, which is a prototype which Meta had revealed recently. Codename Butterscotch, Starburst, Holocake, Mirror Lake. These are all the new kinds of hardware. HTC launched a Viverse phone designed to be compatible with its metaverse platform, incorporating crypto and NFT functionality. And we've also got to remember there are going to be new skills required. So design, social media management inside metaverses. Everything that you thought had been done already is now going to be reproduced inside these metaverses. Every skill and new kinds of jobs. Gig economy inside a metaverse, for instance. Perhaps somebody will mow my lawn or tend to my plants inside the metaverse. Who knows? Maybe. But there are going to be problems, scams, CEOs appearing to be the CEO, but actually not the CEO, using to authorize transfer of funds or disclose protected commercial information. All the kind of scams that we've seen in the internet that we know and love will reappear in the metaverse. Legal sexual harassment is starting to happen inside metaverse platforms. technically speaking, you can get up close and personal into an avatar, but are they being built with the regulatory environment? Can I stop someone coming close to me inside a metaverse? That's a question to be looked at by legal people, by regulators, whoever. Maybe we'll just get tired. We just won't engage. Remember, we all had Zoom fatigue during the pandemic. Perhaps we won't engage nearly as much. And then there are technical issues. Apple's supposed to be launching something next year. There's no sign of it yet. This is a total mock-up, of course. But perhaps this kind of augmented reality version of a metaverse might appear. But there are such huge technical problems. How do you beam a light inside somebody's eyeball from a pair of these? Extremely, extremely hard. So there are tons of unsolved questions about the metaverse. Facebook has sold 10 million of the Quest 2 at cost. It made no money from selling the Quest 2. Zero. That's how much it's trying to win this next game. Standards will be an issue. Where's the HTML of the metaverse? Nobody's invented it yet. There's something called the Metaverse Standards Forum, led by the Kronos Group. It includes Meta, Microsoft, Epic Games, Adobe, NVIDIA, Sony, Unity, and others. But it does not include Niantic, Apple, Roblox, or Snap. So there are no standards as such yet. So it took us 36 years to get to a billion users on the internet, and it's expected that we could have as many as 5 billion users in the metaverse by 2030, if any of this stuff works. Well, that's about half the time it took to get 5 times the number of users. But there's, ladies and gentlemen, there's no smoke without a fire in the old phrase. For the metaverse is clearly happening, even if the players are keeping their cards close to their chest. US consumers expect to spend almost 4 hours per day in the metaverse in 5 years' time. They expect it to happen. These massive companies are doing their damnedest to make it happen, and we still have to see if it will happen at all. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to say thank you very much for listening. I hope you have a great day at ICT Spring. I'll be wandering around, and I hope to see you in the metaverse in the next few years. Thank you so much. Ciao.